With the agent feature, ChatGPT transforms from a chat-based assistant to a fully virtual one, because now, using its own desktop environment, it's able to complete real-world tasks. Because now it's able to access websites and do actions on them on your behalf, like clicking here or signing up or downloading something. And of course, we can use it for marketing purposes. So here are 5 tips. Tip number 1, ask it to conduct CRO audits. Since now it's able to fully browse websites, you can ask it to audit your own website or your competitors. So you can use this prompt and also make sure to always enable the agent feature here. I'm going to share all of the prompts in this video with you guys in the description, so make sure to check them out. But here we're going to have an example, which is checking the N8N website. So with this agent, it's going to go to n8n.io. It's going to browse the whole website, and then it's going to do the following. It's going to check usability and user experience to see if it's easy to navigate. It's going to check if it's following CRO's best practices. It's going to check if it has any unique elements that are not currently trending when it comes to website CRO best practices. And also, it's going to give me some actionable recommendation based on these insights. You click on enter. And now this is where the cool part happens. ChatGPT agent is going to set up its own desktop. And then it's going to browse to n8n.io. And then it's going to check it out, click on different sections, and give me insights. You can see here now how it's setting up everything. It went to the website, and now it's clicking everywhere to check what I asked for, which is, you know, navigation, best practices, and stuff like that. It's going to take a few minutes, but I'm going to jump right into the end result to show you how it looks like. Eventually, when it's done, it's going to give you this really detailed, you can say, report for each section. So this is for usability and user experience. And for every single insight, it's going to give you a reference. So you can click on it and know exactly what it meant and which section it's talking about, which is, I would say, pretty cool. So we have one for user usability and user experience. We have a table, which is what's working well when it comes to best practices, and also what's missing, which is an opportunity for you if you're auditing your competitor's website. We also have unique elements and actionable recommendations. And at the end, a summary. So this is something that used to take hours, but now it's literally taking minutes. Tip number 2, analyze the active ads of your competitors. At the moment, every major social media platform, they have an ads library. And this enables you to check the active ads of any company you want. So let's say in this example, I go to Meta's ads library just to check what kind of ads HubSpot is promoting. Now, of course, this is only Meta, which means we're looking at Facebook ads and Instagram ads. But Google, they have something similar, and also LinkedIn. So you can also do this for these platforms. But let's say in this one, HubSpot, I want to check what they have from a visual point of view. So what kind of visuals are they using in their ads, and also what kind of copy? So you can go to ChatGPT. Once again, make sure that the agent feature is enabled, and you can find this prompt that will also be in the description. So go to Meta's ads library and review all active English language ads from HubSpot. And of course, you can personalize this prompt by changing this to any language you want and any company you want. So analyze them to identify patterns and trends when it comes to ad copy and visual style. And you run it, and the same thing will happen. ChatGPT agent is going to set up its own desktop environment. It's going to go to Meta's ads library. It's going to check this page out. It's going to go ad by ad and identify trends. Now, there's few things you have to fix in this prompt, because in this case, HubSpot, they have more than maybe 100 active ads. So if the agent's going to go through them one by one, it's going to take lots of time. So add additional conditions in your prompt. Like if you see similar ads, skip them. You can only analyze 10 or 20 ads, and that's enough for you. So also be very cautious when you're writing your prompt, because it might take forever if one company has more than 500 ads. In this case, it's analyzing everything. And one thing you have to also be aware of, sometimes this agent won't be able to easily find this page, which is HubSpot. So what you can do if you feel it's stuck somewhere is you go here, then you take over browser, and then, like you say, it's okay, I understand. And once you take over the browser, you can manually yourself select the right page. As you can see here, I can select anything I want. And then I click on finish controlling, and then it's going to analyze the right page. So if you think when you're watching the agent do its thing, that's doing something wrong, you can take over and you can guide it into the right direction. It's going to take obviously a few minutes for you to see any result. So while you wait, I'm going to obviously share with you the end product, which looks something like this. You can see that it shared insight about copy trends with, once again, examples and references. Tip number 3, SEO. Since this agent is able to go on Google and search for anything, it's also able to click on the links in the first page. So you can do the following. You can write this prompt. You are an SEO strategist. Do the following. Search Google for the query and make sure to add your own keyword. In this example, it's workflow automation for beginners. For you, it could be something else. We're going to make sure that it ignores ads and only focus on organic results and accept cookies if needed. And then for each article, give us the following insights. Make sure that the agent is on. We click on enter. And now, once again, it's setting up its own desktop version. And this time it's going to go on Google. It's going to search for my keyword and start clicking and reading the articles in the first page. In my case, in this prompt, it was only 3 articles, but feel free to change this into 4, 5, 6, 7. You can go wild. And you can see here now how it's browsing the web and reading these articles. After a few minutes, you should end up with something like this. So you can see here for article number 1, which is by Zapier, we have the title and the URL, the main keywords, the content length and structures, and we have the same thing for the second article from Kissflow and the third article from ByFi. And based on all of their trends, we come up with a nice report on what to replicate and what to also do to hopefully rank high. You can see here that we have an action plan to create a competitive article with lots of cool insights from the keyword to focus on, the structure of the article, and the rest goes on. Tip number 4, analyze audience sentiment. This is super relevant for e-commerce businesses because this enables you to analyze reviews, whether it's for your own product or your competitors. So you can understand what people like the most and what people like the least. And based on these insights, you can improve your product and your positioning. So you can run this prompt. In this example, I use this product listing. It has more than 500 reviews. So you can either specify a certain listing or you can tell the agent to go online, search different listings, merge the reviews together and give you insights. But in this example, I shared this Amazon listing link and I told it to provide an overall sentiment rating. It did exactly that. So it was able to understand the reasons behind their satisfaction, gratitude, surprise, frustration, and disappointment. And overall, it told me it was mostly positive, but I was able to understand what people like the most. So maybe I can highlight that in my communication and my ads. Tip number 5, improving your value proposition. One thing you can do with this agent is to understand how your competitors are communicating their own value propositions. You can identify trends and gaps and then come up with headlines that stand out. So one prompt you can use is this one. You can say, what are the headlines, subheadlines, and CTA of the first 5 websites that appear organically when you search for, and then you can add your own value proposition. In this example, I used Landing Page Builder, and I made sure that this agent avoids sponsored ads and only focus on organic results. And you can see it was able to check the headline and subheadline of every single competitor. And then at the end, it gave me a summary of how I can improve my own so I can stand out. I hope that you found this video helpful. So make sure to like and subscribe because more videos are coming your way.